Hey everyone, this is Tom with the Green Dot Group. So excited that you're joining us for another Improvement Nerds video where we talk about all things improvement. Today, I'll be answering the question, what is waste? Before I dive into that, I'd like to encourage you to subscribe to our channel and hit the notification button so you're notified when we upload videos in the future. Also, if you like what you see, leave a comment and let us know what you think. Let's jump in and answer the question, what is waste? As you may know, waste is a term that is used to describe any activity within your operations that does not create value for your customers. In other words, it's anything that the customer would not willingly pay for should they know it existed. Organizations that commit to identifying and reducing waste are, in a sense, committing to the lean principles of maximizing value for their customers and for their operators. To help individuals across the organization understand what waste is, lean practitioners have developed several acronyms to help making recalling the forms of waste simpler. If you were to do research on the common forms of waste, it's likely that you're going to come across a handful of these acronyms, which include DOTWIMP, TIMWOOD, and DOWNTIME. You'll notice that in two of the examples, there are seven forms of waste, and then in the third is eight forms of waste. There is variation in how many forms of waste are believed to exist. Originally, Toyota Production Systems, TPS, one of the key contributors to the concept of waste, had identified seven forms of waste. In recent times, an eighth form of waste has been included. That form of waste is non-utilized talent, the N of downtime. At the Green Dot Group, we choose to use the downtime acronym to teach the common forms of waste. Let's jump in to the downtime acronym and talk about each individual form of waste. The acronym downtime stands for defects, overproduction, waiting, non-utilized talent, transportation, inventory, motion, and extra processing. We're going to look at each of these elements individually in the upcoming slides. Let's start with the first form of waste on the list, defects. A defect is any product or service that is incompatible with the customer's expectations. When a defect occurs, operators often have to scrap that product or that service or do service recovery or create a new product in the form of rework. Clearly understanding your customer's expectations is a good first step in avoiding making errors and creating the form of waste that is defects. The next form of waste is overproduction. Overproduction occurs when the organization doesn't fully understand the customer's demand. Because they don't understand customer demand, they create more products than are necessary. Having excessive products on hand is wasteful to the business for multiple reasons. One is that these items have to be stored as inventory. A risk in storing inventory is potentially that the item will expire prior to delivering it to the customer. The next form of waste is waiting. Waiting is any delay that occurs within the process in which customers, parts, people, or the process itself sit idle. In order to reduce waste, the organization needs to seek to create flow. Flow is the movement of the process in a way that is uninterrupted and not impeded. In other words, bottlenecks or barriers to the process have been identified and removed. The next form of waste is non-utilized talent. Your operators and your human resources are a critical input to your organization's operations, ensuring that every operator is maximized and that we are using their complete skills and talent is important to maximizing them as a resource and as an individual. To avoid the form of waste, non-utilized talent, organizations should consider cross-training their operators and seeking to have their operators work at the top of their license. Transportation is the unnecessary or excessive movement of products and materials within the operations. Transportation is often caused by poor facility layout and planning. As mentioned, as part of overproduction, inventory is the form of waste that includes excessive parts and products on hand. These items need to be stored and oftentimes incur high storage costs. Additionally, there's the risk of spoilage. In order to reduce inventory costs, an organization needs to better understand the customer's demand and have just enough supplies on hand to satisfy that demand. A key approach to reducing inventory is to adopt a just-in-time inventory management mindset. Another approach to reducing inventory is to design your processes with pull in mind. In a pull system, the process is not initiated until the product or service is requested by the customer. We previously talked about the form of waste transportation. Transportation is the movement of products or materials. These are inputs that actually create value. Motion is similar to transportation, but slightly different. Motion does not contribute value to the process. Motion is summarized as the unnecessary movement of people, the operator, a team member, or the customer. This includes bending, reaching, lifting, and other ergonomics. The last form of waste within the downtime acronym is extra processing. Extra processing is waste that is caused by gold plating or creating higher quality that is required by the customer. That concludes the forms of waste that are summarized using the downtime acronym. It's recommended that your organization adopt an acronym and teach your operators and the leaders of the organization what the common forms of waste are. To help you achieve this objective, I've developed an infographic to summarize the common forms of waste within the downtime acronym. This resource is available to download. I'd encourage you to download it and share it across your organization with key stakeholders that you think might find it relevant. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you did, I'd appreciate if you could subscribe to the channel and hit the notification button so that you're notified when I upload videos in the future. Also, I'm curious to hear what your thoughts are about this video and what forms of waste you see within your operation and plan to target as part of better understanding what the forms of waste are. As always, thanks for nerding out with us.